Nearly 77,000 total people were in Comerica Park this weekend, hoping to see Miguel Cabrera hit home run number 500. But that didn't happen. But instead, fans saw Cleveland starter Tristan McKenzie start the game with 23 straight outs. But the Tigers' Harold Castro's single with two outs in the eighth inning ended McKenzie's bid for a perfect game in Cleveland's 11-0 win over the Tigers. The Tigers are off tonight before opening up a three-game series at home against the LA Angels tomorrow night. The Yankees may have lost the marquee event of their three-game series with the White Sox, but they did win the last two games with a 5-3 win over the White Sox yesterday, moving to 2.5 games out of the wildcard spot. The White Sox host the Oakland A's tonight at 8 o'clock. The Cubs had an 11-game losing streak earlier this season. Now they have another one to match. This has the Cubs lost to the Miami Marlins 4-1 in South Florida. The Cubs head on the road tonight to face the last team they beat when they take on the Cincinnati Reds tonight at 7:10. NFL preseason this weekend, the Lions lost to Buffalo 16-15 on Friday. Saturday, the Bears beat Miami 20-13. And on Sunday, the Colts beat Carolina 21-18. The WNBA season picked up again after their Olympic break with all the league's teams in action. The Chicago Sky beat Seattle 87-85 in overtime, and the Indiana Fever lost at the LA Sparks 75-70. At the NBA Summer League on Sunday, Memphis beat the Bulls 96-91. A.J. Allmendinger won yesterday's Brickyard 200 on the Indianapolis Motor Speedway's road course, a race that had two major crashes in the final five laps alone. Sunday in Minor League Baseball's High A Central League, Lake County beat West Michigan 4-3 in 12 innings. Fort Wayne topped South Bend 6-1. It was Lansing over Dayton 5-4, and Wisconsin beat Great Lakes 8-6. For more sports and scores from last night and the schedule for today's games, visit the podcast page on this station's website. With your morning sports for Monday, August 16th, I'm Dave Wolfe.